want to thank God for this wonderful opportunity. For God has given me here to share with you all. And this message, as I was preparing, I was challenged and encouraged by God that what God has done in my life, this message would be more of a testimony of my life, what God has done, and out of also experience I want to share with you all. So the topic for this evening is serving the Lord with all of your heart. So this is something God was speaking to me, and I will start with a brief testimony of how God helped me to understand this word. So in 2008, when I first got to know the Christ, and you know, each one of us, when the background that we come from, I came from Hindu background, and I'm sure you must have experienced that bubbling joy when we got to know the Christ, when God revealed himself to us. So going back to almost 11, 12 years back, 2008, when God worked in my life, there was such a great joy in my heart that would, always I used to feel in myself that I must do something, serve the Lord or do something, whatever God has placed around me or whatever area that I could be help of. So I was attending, I was part of one church, and I used to go there, and it was about 300, 400 numbers of congregation. So there was a setup team that, usually in the church, we help to set up the instruments and mics and speakers and all those things. So during that time, I was doing my 3-year degree away from Mumbai, which was in Nhava Sheva near Mumbai. So I used to get Sunday holidays. This course that I was studying is basically for Merchant Navy. So I had to be away from my house for 3 years, and every year there was holiday. So Sunday we used to get holiday. So when I used to come from this college, Sunday first I used to go to Vilipala and first attend the service, and then I would go back to my home, which was in Borivali. And then again in the evening I had to rush to drive almost, say, 120 kilometers, about 120, 150 kilometers from Mumbai to go back to my college where I was studying. So this was my life. And 2009 came, then that's how I used to be attending the church services. And every Sunday I would attend, I would not miss single service. And there was such a passion, passion in my heart that I want to do something. And that would just not to satisfy my passion or, but I had that whatever I could do, I could be help, I should, why not? That was what God was doing in my life. So in 2010, when this year came, now since I'm working as a navigating officer in the shipping industry, most of you all know. So 2010 was the first time when I had to be away with my away from my family, friends, and church members. And I was very active in the church, and then suddenly I have to give away everything, and then I have to be joining a ship. So when that came, one of our church member, one sister who shared with me from the verse, Colossians chapter 3, verse 23. We will read that. Colossians chapter 3, verse 23 says, "Whatever you do, do your work heartily, as for the Lord rather than for men." And verse 24 says, "Knowing that from the Lord you will receive the reward of your inheritance. It is the Lord Christ whom you serve." So as I was joining my ship, this particular sister who came to me, and she shared this verse with me, and I really took hold of this verse. And when I started working on the ship, I had to be away for 6-9 months. And whatever work that was given to me, I used to do with all of my heart, sincerely, that I should give my 100% of whatever I have been asked to do. And then I want to share something that usually, we have our seniors. Obviously, I was under chief officer. I was a cadet those days. So chief officer would sometime take surprise visit, and he would like he want to see whether you're doing your work or not. And I you won't believe there were many instances that he came to visit me and see whether what I'm doing. And praise God that I was working. And so whenever I used to work or whenever any assignment was given to me, I used to really do it that even though my seniors are not watching me right now, but Lord is watching with me, so I should give myself. I should really do something that was asked to me as sincerely. So this is what I was doing it on board, and there were many times when my seniors saw me, they appreciated, and this was my life altogether. So God blessed me during this entire course of how you have to serve Lord. So this verse is very clearly says that whatever you do it with all of your heart, as if you are doing to the Lord, not to the men or to get approval of men. So this was something that was spoken to me, and now I'm sharing this after so many years. The reason I'm sharing this because there is a different light that I have right now, which I want to share this evening. The scripture, if you read this context, there Paul is writing about, he's writing to the slaves. Verse, we will read one verse above, which is verse 22. It talks about slaves in all things, obey those who are your masters on earth. Not with external service as those who merely please men, but with sincerity of heart, fearing the Lord. So, and then it says, whatever you do your work heartily as for the Lord rather than for men. So although this verse speaks to the slaves, and it also speaks that how we should be serving our earthly masters, but I believe that whichever area God has placed us, in that area we must serve the Lord. In other words, even though you are in a profession or wherever God has placed us, that is our area where we can really serve the Lord. So here, although this verse talks about to serving the masters who are on earth, but if we think about this, that we are going to serve the Lord Jesus Christ, how much seriousness that would come in our lives, that how we have to serve one another. So this is what something I really was encouraged that in whatever area God has placed us, we must serve the Lord with all of your heart. Now, when we talk about serving the Lord, many of us, we may have this ambition or zeal that, oh, I want to become a preacher, or I want to become a teacher, or share the word, or do ministry. Those things are very good, and those things we have to do that wherever we have been kept. I'm not saying those things are not good. Those things are good. But if you are called to be wherever you are, that is our area to serve the Lord. And like right, for example, we are in the church. Wherever God has placed us, we have to help, give our help, stretch out our help to the elders, and whatever way that we could be help of, we should do that. We need to serve the Lord in that area. But that does not mean that all of us will be called for full-time ministry. Some of us may be called to do the work which we are doing as in a professional field or in any area. So in that area, my emphasis on that whichever area you are right now in your life, we have to serve in a way that we are serving our Lord Jesus Christ. So maybe you must be this evening, you must be a student, or you are just studying, or maybe you are working, or you are pursuing some career or some professional career you are serving. Whichever area God placed you, I believe that we must serve as if we are serving the Lord. We must do it with all of our heart. So after many years now, I have become chief officer. So I have been assigned some crew under me whom I supervise, and I give them tasks to do. There are a lot of things that goes around on the ship, which we needs to be carried out on time. For example, maintenance part and all those things. So when I assign some work to my juniors, it's not so difficult to find out whether they have done their work with wholeheartedly or not. I believe all of you will agree. And you yourself will also know whether you are doing anything that is not completely, or anything that you are doing which is not 100% of yourself. So it's not difficult to find out whether you are cheating someone or not that way. So I want to share my experience that when I was on board, there were many crew who comes from Philippines, Filipino crew. When they are under me, given this crew and take them and get the work all done also at the same time. I have noticed out of my experience, I'm saying that am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Okay, thanks, Ravi. There was some network issue here in my area. Okay. So when they are there and when they are working, I can easily find out whether they are sincere or not. Sometimes they are, they are not as efficient, or the output is not as great as I'm expecting, but they're doing it sincerely. So what I understand here is that God is not looking to our ability, whether how much we are able to give our 100% out of what you call, are we able to do that, to carry out that work so well or not. God is looking inwardly. God is looking at our wholeheartedly. Are we doing it or not? Are we sincere enough to do whatever we have been given, any task that we have been given around us? So that is what I have faced many crew who are not as efficient, but that's okay. I can train them. That's my job to train them and make them more efficient as a senior officer. But what I could see is that their heart, whether they are doing their work sincerely with all of their heart or not. Now, when others who do not have this understanding you see, they have not that they do not have this understanding that they are doing as if they are doing to the Lord, they are doing to the men. Now, how much more we as a believer, as a Christian, when we know our Lord and when we know these words, how much more we should be giving ourselves, or how much 100% should be giving ourselves to do anything that we are doing, that as if we are doing to the Lord Jesus Christ. That really took hold of me that, oh, that is really something that we need to be set example before others, that how we should place ourselves in wherever areas that we are in. So another thing I want to share, that Jesus, as we take example of Jesus, Lord Jesus is the best example that I can give, the way he humbled himself and became bond servant. If we read in Philippians chapter 2 verse 7, it says that he emptied himself, taking the form of a bond servant. Now whenever Paul writes his letter, he describes, if you read in Romans chapter 1, he describes himself, Paul, a bond servant. What is the meaning of this bond servant? Now, all of these apostles, they were bond servant. Now, this bond servant, we will look into this meaning of this bond servant. Bond servant is the Greek for this word means a slave who completely belongs to his owner, and a servant who willingly chooses to serve his master. Now, Jesus, who were bond servant of he became a bond servant, it says, and even all these apostles who were bond servant, they were slave who belonged to the owner or belonged to the master. So we all of us, we belong to Lord Jesus Christ, and we are also servant who willingly chooses to serve our master. So there are some slaves who are bought, or rather they are slave, but there are others who are also servant who willingly chooses to be with their master for a long time. During initially there were these slave who would serve their master forever their life, and after some time they could be released. There were things like that. but then they have choice afterwards. Do they want to serve the master or not? So this is something that really encouraged me, that Jesus, who became born servant, he took the form of man. He emptied himself, and he was so submissive to the Lord, to his God. So he, as a son of God, was, when he came to the earth, he was so submissive to God to follow him completely. Now, when we talk about serving the Lord, serving is also, we'll read in John chapter 12, what Jesus speaks about serving. John chapter 12, verse 26, which says, "If anyone serves me, he must follow me." Now, when Jesus speaks about here, "If anyone serves me, he must follow me." And further it says, "And where I am, there my servant will also be. If anyone serves me, this Father will honor him." What a wonderful promise. So when we serve Lord, Jesus says, "If anyone serves me, he must follow him. We must follow him." Now, follow Jesus, or seeing Jesus, in other words, is taking up or deny ourselves each day by day. I mean to say, although we do not like to follow, but if we deny our will out of our flesh, we will not want to follow. But we must deny ourselves and follow, choose to follow Christ. If we want to serve in any area of our life, that is the thing. And so when Jesus, if all of us remember this verse, that where Jesus washes his disciples' feet, he was demonstrating that all the apostles who were there, that we were called to become a servant. How we can become a servant? By following Christ, and also by being submissive to the whatever God has place in our area, that we should be in a way that we will submit ourselves in every area. So my emphasis for today evening is to encourage you all of you to take this attitude, following this attitude of being servanthood in any area of your life that God has placed you. And I want to read one scripture in Malachi chapter 3. Verse 18. It gives us a scripture here. It says, so you will again distinguish between the righteous and the wicked, between one who serves God and one who does not serve him. We have been called to serve the Lord. We have been called to become servant in every area of our life. We have been called, and God is going to distinguish us as a righteous or as a wicked. So that is something that God touched me, and how we have to distinguish ourselves, whether we are serving or not, is by looking our life, whether we are following God or not. That is what I understand. And also when we are serving the Lord, or if we are not able to serve in any area of our life, we need to remind ourselves, especially how we will know that we are not serving the way we should serve. In any area, God will, you will know that whether you are doing your best or not in any area that you are working or whatever you're doing. I think also if we are, let's say, we are serving the Lord, and we, we try to take shortcuts. Many times we try to take shortcuts, and there may be many reasons behind it, and God will reveal it to you. Especially the danger that I feel, that if you're not able to serve the Lord, there will be some danger which is to do with yourself. There would be some hidden pride in you that will stumble you, or that will basically come on your way, that will not allow you to serve him completely. And that is one area which I believe that we must be. I mean, I remind, as this message I speaks to myself also, that I must remind myself when I have been given higher rank or higher position, whether is there any area that I am taking pride and I'm not able to serve the Lord in the area or in the in the responsibility that I must carry out? Is there any area that I'm not doing that? So with that, I would like to encourage once again all of you, brothers and sisters, wherever God has placed you, let us have this attitude of being servant, in servanthood, that we will serve with all of our heart, not leaving anything, any single person that we should take up or you know, try to cheat, but serve the Lord with all of heart. It does not necessarily that we will be called to do the ministry, but wherever God has placed us, whichever area God has placed us, let us serve the Lord and follow Him. We all of us are called to be servant. Praise God, and that is the end.